It's time for me to do a report about this construction site. We're on the Bedford Highway, and I just talked to these guys and I told them what they're doing. You can't see it on this video, but up the street here for about 3 or 4 miles, they got the whole lane blocked. Took me half an hour to come up here, and they are working over here on the road doing this work. I'm doing a video, okay? You want to talk on video? Okay. So I asked these guys why they have to block the lane right here, which is a really busy road. This right turn lane, every time somebody wants to go up there, they make a right, and I'll show you, I'll keep this video going to show you what happens. When somebody has to make a right, two or three cars, they end up blocking all the traffic. And I said to these guys, why do you have this lane blocked? They're not doing any construction here. There's no reason for this. I said to him, why don't you unblock this lane right here? And they said, well, what are we gonna do when we're working on the sidewalks? I said, when you need to block the lane, you block it. Right now, they don't need to block this lane. So I'm gonna have to wait to show you. It took me a half an hour to come down to this point when it should have only taken me 2 minutes. So far, I haven't been able to show you in this video people making right turns, because when I was there, when you make a right, you're supposed to go on the right here. I'm gonna walk down and show you how this works. And then I'm gonna turn around, come back, and get the company's name on the video. So this car here might be making a right. As soon as we get a car that's making a right, what happens is they make a right, and right there with our red cars, there's a set of lights. So when you're trying to make a right, two or three cars make a right turn, they have to stop for the red light, and the cars are backed onto the main road. This is a very busy street up here. Do you see any reason why this lane should be blocked? Absolutely no reason. They want to make it easy for these trucks to back up once in a while. Well, if they did a little bit of traffic control, when the truck needs to back in here, they had a flag guy and they would stop the cars. But no, instead, they blocked the whole lane off. There's usually a lot of cars making right turns here. Of course, in this video, I started up and there's nobody making a right turn. So, it's making a liar out of me, because when I came up here, this was all full of cars. And I said to the guys, there's no need for them to be blocking this lane right here. And there isn't. You can see. What you can't see back there is that the cars are backed up about 3 miles down the street. And what normally takes 5 minutes is taking a half an hour. And this is a very busy road. It's a shame that I'm not getting anybody making right turns to show you what was happening. I think what's happening right now is this bottleneck these guys are causing is slowing the cars down so much that this traffic right here is empty for that reason. If I walk down the street a little bit over there and I show you, all the way around the bend, all the way down the Bedford Highway, this construction is blocking it. I understand traffic, they block traffic, but there's no need to have this lane blocked. And this sidewalk here being under construction normally, well, there's a sign over there, okay. So I have to keep my video going until we get some cars get bottled up so I can show you what's been happening. I asked the guy, I said, why do you have these cones here? You know, all he needs is about 4 or 5 cones right there. So this big truck, when he comes in to back up, he just pulls into the lane right here and then backs up. And the cones will make sure he can do it. There's no need for the rest of these cones to be here. Okay, he's making a right. Now what happens is, when there's 3 or 4 cars making a right, they have to stop for the light, see? Normally you don't have to stop. You see the green light right here? Well, normally this lane allows the cars to go up. And the only reason why there's not more traffic is because they've got it all blocked back there. So there's 2 cars making a right turn. When you get a third one, it blocks this lane right here. Oh, there's another one. So you can see how having this lane blocked is causing a traffic problem right here. So now he's blocking the intersection, and it gets worse. Well, I guess living in the Maritimes, I guess common sense doesn't exist. And that light right there that turns green for that white van pulling out, that light is very, very short. Usually only one car can get through, and then it turns back to red again. See how those three cars there are blocking the intersection? Because the cars coming across the intersection couldn't go through because the cars were in the way. It's pretty bad when you got to tell people how to do their job. So I'm going to go up here to get the company name on my video to show you what's happening here. I don't know. I guess having gray hair and having driven several million miles in my life, I know how traffic is supposed to work. You know, all you need is about five cones there, right? So the truck can back in. Leave five cones there.
No.
Yeah.
Standing up.
What? Oh, I know that. I'm doing a video. I'm just showing the world what you guys are doing. If you had five cones there, the truck could pull in and back in with no problem. With no problem. But you've got to block the whole road off. It's a work site, yeah, okay. You know, like I explained to the lady, I understand your trucks have got to back up here, right? If you had about five or six cones and left them there, and left the rest of that lane marked with cones, when the truck pulls in, you can just back right up. And you've got people that can control the traffic. You don't need to block this traffic all day long like this.
Well, partner.
No, I know.
You don't even have a hard hat or vest. You're not even on our site there.
It's not your site. This is a public sidewalk.
Oh, no.
It's an actual site.
You know what? Hassle me all you want over nothing, okay? I'm glad I'm getting a good video done here. Because I spent a half an hour up there because you don't care about what's happening down the street. What'd you say? Okay, are you threatening me now?
Nothing. You're the one that said you were going to call the cops. Call them and get them here. We'll deal with them then.
Anything else you'd like to say on video?
I'm just helping you, but you don't.
All right. I've been reasonable, and now you're bitching and screaming at me. I didn't come over here screaming. I just explained that everybody up there is held up because you have the right lane lit. When a car makes a right there, okay, they get a green, a red light. Three cars pull out, they block the lane. Man. You know what? I asked who the supervisor was. You don't even have a supervisor here. Oh, I can do whatever I want in public. I've been doing videos for years. I'm a reporter. What do you know? You should go check out my website to see all the reports I've done about road hazards that government causes. Telling me I'm not allowed. Oh, construction site. They think the city's a construction site. So they're causing a bottleneck. I may as well walk over here and show you. You can see how bad this is. The real problem here is that the city shouldn't allow this in the daytime during rush hour when there's so many cars out here. And if people want to cross the street, they can't push the button right there to change the light. Hey, how am I supposed to push the button to change the light? Okay, I hope you're enjoying this video. You'll notice that these company trucks don't have a name on them. Oh, STL. No, that's not it. This is a terrible way to do work. So now you can see back here just how bad the traffic jam is. This is a lane that comes in off the highway. So it's probably backed up a couple of miles. And, you know, they worry about the environment. They worry about fuel economy and stuff like that. You think of all the thousands of cars that are being held up for this little construction site that they have going on here. You know, if more people did reports like I do, and the public started being concerned and knowing what's happening, these things wouldn't happen. So now you're having a look and see what it's like to have stupidity in charge in the city of Halifax Regional Municipality. Now look at this, boy. If you ever had a wheelchair and you had to go through here, you couldn't. They should be making these sidewalks safe for wheelchairs, and they're not. And safe for pedestrians. Look at this one. There's not enough gravel in here. It's like that at all of them. And you can't reclose this sidewalk. What's the name of this company? There's no way for me to know what the name of the company is. I guess other people are very busy and they don't have time to do reports like I'm doing. Well, that's the nice thing about being disabled and being self-employed. So now you see the mess that we have. What's the name of your company? No name, eh? What a mess you guys are creating. You got it backed all the way up to the highway. Yeah. They should be doing this off time when the city's not so busy. And the sidewalk down there, you should have the gravel level so people can walk on it. There you go. Another report by the visiting folk photographer.